Well, there you have it. That was the first week of lockdown. I did what I do today. Today was relatively straightforward. I managed to grab one in between the Argos jobs for this morning, which was picking up one of them water rowers. Paying off a lot of money. I spoke to the geezer in the shop. I thought, I don't think I've ever paid that much for a car. You know, them ones where you row and it's got a swishy thing on the end. And that had to go up to Bromington, somewhere near Birmingham. And then I got one out of Telford, going down to a care home in Bishop Stortford. That was boot-bard kind of wet wipes and stuff like that for the oldies. And that was, you know, up and down. And it was a decent day for, I've hit my target. I've had a good day's money. I did do a bit of damage to the wing mirror, but I think a bit of sellotape won't mind for now, right, you know. So there you go. I'm not going to keep driving you mad. That was it. That was 1 week. We had a week of pre-lockdown, and now we've had a week of lockdown. And so the question is, what's it like? Well, the answer is, okay, there ain't as many jobs on there. And the jobs on there are probably going for a little bit cheaper. And you probably have got a bit further to go and get them. But there are still jobs, you know. And I've got to be honest with you, I've had a busy week. But then having said that, I started Sunday, I've had a 6-day week, and I've had 2 15-hour days. I had the one where I ended up in Cardiff at 1 o'clock in the morning, doing the screens for Tesco's, and I had the one where I started at 9 and finished last night, by the way, the Argos. I got back at about 10:30. I got home about 10:30. I think I got back to Argos at just after 10. So you're looking at a good 8 hours on that one. It's not the greatest, but the question is this, how far are you prepared to go? One of my favourite films ever is The Usual Suspects with Pete Postlethwaite, we can never say, and Kevin Spacey and Gabriel Byrne and all that. And there's a bit in it. If you've not seen it, it's a great film. And if you think you know the twist at the end, you don't. It's brilliant. You sometimes see me wearing a T-shirt that says Cowboy Ashley Purslane on the T-shirt. It's from the film, the Cowboy Ashley thing, right, you know? And there's a bit in it where Gabriel Byrne's talking about the bad guy. And the bad guy in it is the super-duper bad guy. He's like the nastiest gangster ever. And he said the way this geezer come to be about was, he said he realised at one stage, it's not a matter of how many men you've got or guns or cars or all that. It's just a matter of how far are you prepared to go? And I think that is a question. I mean, you can still hit your target. You can still hit over your target. But how far are you prepared to go? Do you want to do a day's work and then realise there's another day's work there and think, I'll take it? Do you want to drive a million miles away from home and sleep in the back of a freezing cold van? Do you want to go to work at weekends? Let's face it, weekends don't even exist anymore because everyone's at home all of the time, including all the kids. Every day is like Sunday. So it is a matter of how far you're prepared to go. The work is there and it's harder, but it is there. And I'm just so grateful. I talked to my mate, David Chris, today. Hello, mate. He's a cab driver. His cab's just sitting on the driveway. There's absolutely no point going out. So I went out one day, took £7. Went out Mother's Day, didn't take a penny. There's no one there. There's no work there. I've got mates at a market traders. My mate, Ken, he's thinking of applying for Pizza Hut. Or pizza delivery, Domino's. I went, why don't you jump on with us, mate? And he don't want to change insurance over. And then I've got my mate Martin, who I love. Hello, Martin. He's had a smasher. He was delivering tables to hospitals this morning, had to build them up. Then he had to deliver another medical delivery. Then he went over Canary Wharf and got something coming back to Hatfield. And then got two jobs coming out of Hatfield. Both of them, like five drop multi-drops. Hatfield. They're all like, you know, within like 0.6 miles, a whole drop. He's getting £50 a hit and he had two hits. I mean, that's a day's work there. He was lucky. I was coming back through Hatfield and be honest, I didn't see it. And if I'd have seen it, I'd have had a go at it. But I've got mine set up so that I couldn't see it. So well done him. He's great. I've known the boy since he was 16 and he's now on a firm, which is brilliant. So, but anyway, that's the long and the short of it. I'll keep doing the videos as time goes by. I'll keep you updated. But I'm hoping that it don't get no worse than this. I think if anything, a few people will go, look, I'm starving to death here. I'm going to have to go back to work. But we're in lockdown, but stuff needs delivering. We've got the medical supplies. We've got the doctor's things. We've got the food thing. And we've got other bits and pieces which are vital. So you can get by. And if you get your head down and go for it, you'll get by properly. And then hopefully when all this is over, it will go mad. Fingers crossed. In the meantime, enjoy your weekend. you know, and I hope you're all doing okay. I hope you're all healthy, and I hope you're able to take care and take money.